I began the program that way for a purpose, because I was remembering this moment in Randall Thompson's counterpoint class. He had addressed a fellow sitting in the front row. I can't remember his name, but he said, "Mr. Smith, do you play the preludes and fugues from the well-tempered clavier?" And the fellow said, "No, Professor Thompson, I'm sorry, I don't." And Randall looked at him intensely and said, "Well, what do you do on Sundays?" That was a joke. That was a Randall Thompson joke. I chose the F sharp because I like it so much, but I chose the C sharp because in Robert Maves's harmony class freshman year, he played that preludium and it made an impression I have never forgot. And I think, what do you think Bach said to himself after he wrote that? "No, pretty good, buddy, pretty good." Another teacher that we all remembered, of course, was G. Wallace Woodworth. And he brought classical music to one generation after another of Harvard students for his incredible enthusiasm. You can't imagine how enthusiastic he was. I was sitting, not in music one, but in a history music class with Jim Weiss, and Woody was going on about the damnation of Faust. He loved Berlioz. And when he got to the infernal birds, he got so excited he started flapping his arms. And Jim and I looked at each other and we thought, oh God, he's gone over the edge. But it was that complete involvement that was so infectious. He had one shortcoming. He underestimated Schubert. I still hear him saying, "Schubert didn't know how to modulate." And I quoted that to Robert Maves, who said, "Schubert didn't know how not to modulate." That was a joke also. That was a lot of nice. The music department was just one laugh after another. I played this this impromptu at a couple of memorial services. It seems to have the tone for that. And well, there's just one classmate, I won't even, he would love to be here, but he died 2 years ago. And he would have loved Schubert.